Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to discuss another problem. Problem is furthest building you can reach. So in this problem we are given an array heights representing the heights of buildings, some bricks and some ladders. So what we are given in the problem, we are given this array which is representing the height of each building and bricks and ladders. You start your journey from building 0. That is, it's zero base indexing, guys, right? So 0, 1, 2, 3. So we'll be starting from zero building and move to the next building by possibly using bricks or ladders. So either we have to use bricks or ladders to move to the next building. While moving from building I to I plus 1, that is from one building to the next building, if the current building height is greater than or equal to next building height, right? For example, let's say we have a building, right? Let's say we have a building from a height, like this building has height 10 and the next building has height 5. So if this current building height is greater than the next building height, then we can directly jump. Okay, there is no need to use bricks or ladders. But if the case is something like this, that the current building is 5 and the next building height is 10. So then we'll have to use either bricks or ladders. Okay. So this is what the problem is. Alright. So now let's see further. Return the farthest building height for this building index you can reach if you use the given ladders and bricks optimally. So we need to go to the farthest building, okay? And for that we need to use ladders and bricks, and the answer should be the farthest index, okay? So now let's see some test cases, right? Let's see some test cases, and with the test cases we'll get to know the approach. So let's discuss this test case first. So heights of the building are these, and bricks and ladders. So let me, I have written these, so just give me a minute. Okay. So let's say we have something like this. So this is the test case which is given to us, right? So see, this is the test case which is given to us, and no, this is not that test case. So that is here. So here what we are given is that number of bricks are 5, ladder is 1, and this is the height of the building. So we are initially at the 0th building. Okay. So see guys, now the next building has height 2, which is less than 4. So if the height of the building, next building is less than the current building, right? So then we can just simply go, no need to use any bricks or ladder, we can simply go to the next building. Okay, after that, now this is the current building 2 and the next building is 7. So 7 is greater than the current building height, so we need to use some bricks or ladders. Okay, see, obviously guys, this is larger, right? And this 2 is smaller building. So in order to go to this building, we'll have to use either ladder or bricks. So let's say we are using ladders. We are using bricks, okay? We are using bricks. So how many bricks will be required? What is the height difference? In this question, it's given that the number of bricks required will be the height of the next building minus height of the current building. So 7 minus 2 will be 5. So 5 bricks will be required. So we will go to this building. And how many bricks will be left? 5 minus 5? 0. Alright. Now what we will do? Now we have to go to the next building, but 6 is the building which is height less than the current building which is 7, so we can directly go to this building. Now from 6 to 9 we need to go, but right now we do not have any bricks, right? So what we can do, we can use the ladder. So ladder, there is no constraint on the height difference. With ladder you can jump to any building, right? So from this we will go to this building. Ladder will be 0 now. One ladder was there and we have used it. So now we do not have any bricks, do not have any ladder. Okay, so this is the, this four index is the last building we can reach. Last building we can reach. All right. Okay, now let's discuss one more test case. So let's say we have this test case. Let me erase this. So for this test case, this is the second test case. For this we have bricks 10 and ladders 2. So bricks are 10 and ladders are 2. Initially we are at this building. So 4 to 12, right? How much is the height difference? 12 minus 4, it's 8. So let's say we have to use 8 bricks. So from this to this, we go, and how many bricks are used? 8 bricks are used. So how many bricks are left? 2 bricks are left. So from 12 to 2, 2 is height less than 12, so we can directly go. Okay. So from 2 to 7. So 7 is greater than 2. So how many bricks we will require? 7 minus 2, 5. But right now we do not have 5 bricks, we only have 2 bricks. So we'll have to use ladder for that. So ladder will be, one ladder will be used and one will be left. So from here to here, we use one ladder. So from 7 to 3, 3 is less height, so we can just directly go. So from 3 to 18, how many bricks will be required? 15 bricks. But we do not have that many bricks, so again we will use a ladder. One ladder. And then it will be 0. And then from 18 to 20, how many bricks are required? 20 minus 18, 2 bricks. And we have 2 bricks. So we can use 2 bricks and we can go to 20. So from this 20 we have to go to 3 and its height less height than 20, so we can directly go. Okay, so here we come at here at 3, and after 3 bricks are also 0 and ladder is also 0, so we cannot go farther than this 3. So this 7 index will be the farthest building index. Output will be 7. Okay. Now some of you might be thinking that why initially we are using bricks, right? Why can't we use ladders? So let's use ladders also. You'll better understand. So see. Bricks were how much? 10. And ladder was 2. Ladder were 2. So first of all, we are initially here. So for 4 to 12, in order to go from 4 to 12, we will use one ladder. So instead of using bricks, earlier we used bricks, right? Now we'll use ladder. So one ladder will be left and one ladder will be used here. So from 12 to 2, we can directly go. From 2 to 7, we can use a ladder again. Ladder will be 0. So 7 to 3, we can directly go. And now from 3 to 18, how many bricks are required? 18 minus 3, which is 15. But now we do not have 15 bricks, right? Only 10 bricks we have, and ladders are 0 now. So here we will stuck. Here we will not go further. So 4 will be the max, the maximum index of the building we can reach. But ideally 7 is greater than 4, right? So we have to, what was the question? We have to return the farthest building index. So that's why it's beneficial. See, it's beneficial to use bricks first. So I hope this was clear. Now let's discuss one more test case so that you are completely clear with the approach. So see. Now let's discuss this test case also. So this is the third test case. In this, bricks are 17 and ladders are 0. So bricks are 17, ladders are 0. We are initially here. We have to go from this to this. 3 is less height than 14, so we can directly go. From 3 to 19, how many bricks? 16 bricks. And we have 17, so 1 will be left and 16 bricks will be used here. So from 19 to 3, 3 is smaller height than 19, we can directly go. So 3 will be the output, that is the farthest index. Okay, 3. Now guys, from the approach, right, from the approach, what you just, I hope you understood all the test cases, and from all the test cases, try to think of an approach, right? Just see this test case which we discussed, right, in which we were using ladder earlier and not bricks we were using. So from this test case, it was obviously clear that first we have to utilize the bricks, and if the bricks are not sufficient, then we have to use the ladder. All right, I hope this was clear. So what approach we are thinking? The approach which we are thinking is that first of all, we will use all the bricks. Like, we will first of all use bricks, and if the bricks are not sufficient, for example, we have two, our current, how many bricks we have is 5, and the height difference is 10. We need 10 bricks, but right now we have 5 bricks. So if bricks are not sufficient, then we use ladder. Okay, this is the approach which we are currently thinking of. Okay. So that means first we will try to utilize all the bricks, and then we will try to utilize all the ladder. So let's see the code once for this. And right now, see, LeetCode has, I think this is wrong on LeetCode's part, because in the test cases, all the test cases which are given here are satisfying this approach, right? Okay. But this approach will not work for all the test cases. We will discuss the test case for which it will not work. But right now, let's see the code once for this approach. Okay. So this function is given to us for this building, and it has height, bricks and ladder. So we have taken this variable max reach, which will store the maximum index we can go to, and we are traversing each building. We are finding the difference of the current of the next building with the current building. If the difference is less than 0, meaning the next building has height 5 and the current has 10, so we can directly go, right? So no need to use any brick or ladder. In that case, we will just update a max reach and we will just continue. Okay, max reach will be I plus 1 because we are going to the next next building. So max reach will be I. If I is the current index, max reach will be I plus 1, that is this index. Otherwise, if difference is not negative, it means we will first of all check if the number of bricks which are required are sufficient, like we have that many bricks. If yes, we have that many bricks, we will decrease the difference, which is the required. See, this difference you can say is X. Okay. And the bricks are the current bricks, how many we have. So we will decrement that count from the bricks, total bricks. Otherwise, if we do not have that many bricks, we will see if they have ladders. So we will update the max reach and we will decrement the ladders. Otherwise, if we do not have ladders, and we do not have that many bricks also, so we will just return max reach, the current index. And if bricks are also less than 0 and ladder is also less than 0, in that case also we will return max reach. Okay, so this is the approach. And initially you will think that, okay, by seeing these test cases, that okay, this approach is working. So this is the test case. All right. So in this test case, if we use our approach, okay, so see what will happen. First of all, we will use all the bricks. So here, how many bricks are there? So we have 4 bricks. So we have, in this test case, we have how many bricks? We have 4 bricks and 1 ladder. So what we will do? First of all, we will utilize all the bricks, right? With that is what we were doing. So how many bricks will be required? We are initially here. So 5 minus 1 will be 4. 4 bricks are required and we have 4 bricks. So we will use 4 bricks and we will come here. And bricks will be 0 now. So from 5 to 1, 1 is less than 5. So we can directly go to 1. Now from 1 to 2, वी हैव टू हैव वन ब्रिक बट देर आर नो ब्रिक्स सो वी हैव टू यूज लैडर सो वील यूज लैडर एंड वी विल कम टू टू सो नाउ वी कैनॉट गो फ्रॉम टू टू थ्री बिकॉज वी हैव नो ब्रिक्स नो लैडर सो मैक्सिमम इंडेक्स वी कैन गो इज थ्री राइट मैक्सिमम इंडेक्स वी कैन गो टू इज थ्री बट गाइज दिस इज नॉट द ऑप्टिमल सोल्यूशन why this is not optimal let's see one another case how we can do this so test case is 1 5 1 2 3 4 and 10000 and index is 0 1 2 3 4 and 5 and 6 okay so see earlier what we were doing we were using brick here right we were using bricks here We have how many bricks? We have four bricks and ladder also we have one. So, now let's do one thing. Instead of using brick, we will use ladder. So, from going to 1 to 5, we'll use one ladder. So, ladder will be 0. Then from 5 to 1, we can directly go. Now from 1 to 2, how many bricks are required? 2 minus 1, 1 brick. So, we will use one brick. Three bricks will be left and here one brick will be used. So from 2 to 3 how many bricks? 1 brick. So we have bricks we can reduce one and we can use one brick here. Then again from this to this how many bricks we require? 4 minus 3 1 brick we require and we have 2 bricks so we can use one and one will be left. And from this 4 to 10,000 obviously we cannot go. So this is a max index we can go 5. So guys see earlier what was happening? Earlier we were only going to 3 index. But here we are going to 5 index. So output optimal answer is 5 because we have to go to farthest building. Okay. So from this now you might be thinking that that approach is not correct. Like using the bricks. That is not correct. But just that approach we need to change a little bit. So that we can accommodate these kind of cases also. Alright. So let's discuss how we can do that. So see what we will do right we will be using bricks only initially we will use bricks only okay we will use bricks only initially when the bricks will be zero like when bricks will be less than zero we will use ladder okay so why this we will do see wherever we have used maximum bricks right that we will replace with a ladder so that we can accommodate these max bricks for some other case okay so wherever bricks are less than zero we will use a ladder So you will understand this approach. Let's dry run this once on this test case. 1, 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 5, 1, 2 and we have 3, 4 and 10,000. 3, 4 and 10,000. Okay. So see, what we have to do, right? Earlier, what was happening? What was happening that here we have used bricks, right? Here we use bricks. So when after that, like here we have to, here our bricks were finished, right? So we started using ladder. But these were the maximum bricks which were used, right? Four bricks. Instead of this four bricks, we could have also used a ladder. So that these bricks could have used, we can use here, right? So what we will do, right? We will be storing, the maximum number of bricks we are using. So that at times when we require, we can replace that max number of bricks with a ladder. Okay. So how we can do that we have to get every time the maximum number of bricks we used. So how to get something maximum of something, right? We can use a max heap to do that. So we will be using a max heap. So in the code, what we are doing is we are taking this max heap, and this difference is again the height difference. And this max heap will be storing the number of bricks which are used every time. Number of bricks used. That is the difference. Difference is the number of bricks, right? Okay. So let me do the indexing 0, 1, 2, and 6. Let's iterate. So side by side, I will also show the code. Okay. So see, what we have is, we have this height difference. First of all, we'll calculate the height difference. So we are currently here and we will find the difference. So difference is what? 5 minus 1, 4. Okay. Now this difference is not less than 0 or equal to 0, meaning this height of the next building is greater than this building. So we'll have to use either bricks or ladder. So we'll use bricks. So whatever number of bricks are, we'll subtract that from the total number of bricks. Total bricks are how much? Bricks were 4 and ladder was 1. So 4 minus 4, bricks will turn out to be 0. And these 4 bricks are used, so we'll store them in max heap. Max heap dot push the whatever the number of bricks are used. So right now the bricks are not less than 0. Bricks are equal to 0. Right, so we will not do anything, and ladders is also not equal to 0, so we will not do anything. Now we'll go to the next index, that is here. So here difference will be what? Difference will be we have here, so difference will be 1 minus 5. This is the next building, currently we are here, so minus 4. So this is negative. So we will just continue, because we can go to the next building because its height is less than the current building. So now we will calculate for this. So when 1, so here we will be having 2 minus 1, how many bricks we require? 1. So difference is not less than equal to 0, so we come here, we decrement from the bricks. So 0 minus 1, 0 minus 1 will be minus 1. So minus 1, this negative value indicates, right? See guys, this negative value indicates that we have no bricks for this. So we have to use a ladder. Alright, I hope you agree with this. When bricks count will be negative, it means we have to use a ladder. So if bricks are less than 0, we will use a ladder. We will use a ladder, and wherever the maximum number of bricks were used, right, we will replace it with ladder. Okay. That is, we will replace that whatever the maximum bricks we have used, right, we will replace that with a ladder. So ladder will count will decrease. Ladder count will decrease, and those bricks we'll get, right, obviously, minus 1 plus 4, that is 3. Why 3? Because one brick is used from here to here. Okay, so, and this 4 also, since we are not using these bricks now because we have replaced it with ladder, so we will pop it from the max heap. Okay, so this means that now here we have used a brick, that's why three bricks are left, and here in place of using bricks we have used a ladder. Now from 2 to 3 again, what is the difference? टू टू थ्री डिफरेंस इज वॉट वन. सो हाउ मेनी वी हैव ब्रिक्स, हाउ मेनी ब्रिक्स वी हैव थ्री. सो वी विल डिक्रीज, थ्री माइनस टू विल बी वन एंड वन ब्रिक विल बी यूज एंड वी विल गो हेड. सो फ्रॉम थ्री टू फोर अगेन हाउ मेनी ब्रिक्स वी रिक्वायर, फोर माइनस थ्री वन. सो वी विल यूज वन ब्रिक एंड वन विल बी लेफ्ट एंड वील कम टू हियर. And now obviously from this we cannot go to these many bricks. Okay. So what we will see here, bricks 1000, 10,000 minus 4. This will be some 9996, something like this. And 1 minus this will be something 9995, minus 9995. So bricks will be negative. Ladders minus minus. So ladders will become minus 1. And if ladders are minus 1, it means just break. So this is the index we have reached so far, 5. Okay, so I know this was somewhat complicated, but if you understand the concept, then it's very easy. Okay, so let's discuss the time complexity for this. So since we are using a max heap, we have this loop, right? So we are going to each building. So let's say that is we have n buildings. Okay, and let's say this pop and push operation, right, is taking log of the, let's say k are the number of elements in the max heap at a time. So n log k will be the time complexity. As space complexity, we are using a this max heap. So O of k will be the maximum number of, like, let's say the differences. So O of k will be the space complexity. So if you found the video helpful, please like it, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.